Hello! This video is about custom user fields. We'll learn what they are, what kinds of fields you can add, and how you can use them to create unique signup and user experiences. Knowing your users is an important part of running a marketplace business. With the right information, you can segment users into groups, offer them better experiences, and create rich user profiles. That's why Sharetribe lets you create custom user fields. These are fields for specific information you want to collect from users during signup or in user profiles. Together with user types, user fields let you create unique signup and user flows. To get started, navigate to Users and User Fields in Console. To create a new field, click Add a new user field. First, you're asked to enter a field name and an ID. The field name is visible to users as the name of this field in the signup form and user profiles. The field ID is a unique identifier of this custom field that's not shown to users. Next, you choose the field type. The options are free text, number, select one, and select multiple. Below the field type, you determine further settings depending on the type of user field you choose. Next, you can determine user type settings if you want the user field to be limited to users in a specific type only. So let's create some actual user fields. We'll create a custom field in each of these types. You can use the chapter markers in the video timeline to skip to the most relevant one for you. On a real marketplace, especially during signup, you'll want the least amount of friction possible so that people won't abandon the process midway. So choose the custom user fields you add to the signup form carefully and only ask what's absolutely necessary for you to know. We'll start by creating a free text field, which is a free-form text field. It's great for asking specific open details about a user. For example, on a job board, you could ask for previous work experience or URL to a freelancer's portfolio on a design service marketplace. Since I expect some providers or bike owners on my bike rental marketplace to be businesses such as local bike stores, I'll add an optional field for website URLs. I'll fill in the name and an ID, website, and choose free text as the field type. Then I'll enable add this field to the signup form. But I'll disable make this field mandatory as most of my providers will be individual bike owners renting their own equipment and won't have websites. Next, I'll limit this field to providers only, so I check the box limit this field to specific user types. Then I click add a user type ID. The ID for my provider user type is bike-owner, so I add that here. Now, only people who sign up as bike owners will see this field during signup. On to the next custom field. We'll create a number field, which is a field that accepts whole numbers only from a predetermined range. My example will be how many bikes do you own, and I'll add that as a name. The ID will be how many bikes. Then I choose the number field type. I'll add it to the signup form, but make it non-mandatory. Next, I'm asked to determine a minimum and maximum value. I'll enter 1 as the minimum and 10,000 as the maximum. I'll limit this field to providers only, so I check the box limit this field to specific user types and add the user type ID bike-owner. Only bike owners will see this field during signup. Moving on, we'll create a select one field. This field type is a drop-down selection where the user has to choose one option of many. Click to add a new field. On my bike rental marketplace, this field will be biking skill level. Add a name and an ID. Choose the field type select one. I'll add this field to the signup form, but again, make it optional. Speaking of which, we'll need to add some options. There are two default ones which we'll edit first. Fill in an option name and an ID. These work the same as the field name and ID. The name is visible to users and the ID is a unique identifier. After editing the two default options, click Add a new option and add as many options as you'll need. This time, I'll limit the field to customers only, so I check the box Limit this field to specific user types and add the user type ID customer. Now, only customers will see this field during signup. Finally, we're adding a Select Multiple field. This will be a checkbox selection where users can choose one or more out of the provided options. Add a new field and enter in a name and an ID. Mine will be Biking Interests. Click Select Multiple in the field type selection. I'll add this field to the signup form. If you make a select multiple field mandatory, users will need to choose at least one of the options. If it's non-mandatory, they can also choose none. So I'll make this field non-mandatory. Another setting for this field type is if you want the unselected options to be shown on user profiles. When enabled, people can see the options the user did not choose. When disabled, people will only see the options that were selected. I choose the latter, so I'll turn this setting off. Next, you need to edit the default options and click to add as many options as you'll need. Fill in the name and an ID for each. I won't limit this field to any specific user type, as this is a field where people can share more about their interests and build community on my marketplace. You can also reorder the user fields and options within fields by clicking on the 6 dots next to the field card and dragging them up and down. This determines the order of the fields in the signup form and in profiles. And that's our custom user fields. Click to save changes, and your user fields are ready to go. Let's take a look at user fields on your marketplace. When someone decides to sign up for your marketplace, they'll first choose the user type, if you have more than one. Let's sign up as a provider. You can see that the user fields differ based on user type, which we determined in console. The user will fill in the requested information, accept the terms of service and privacy policy, and click sign up. And here's the user profile on your marketplace, where you can see all the user fields we created earlier as public information. The user can also edit their own information at any time. So that's our user fields. Let's recap. Custom user fields are specific information that you want to collect from your users. Together with user types, you can use them to create unique signup experiences for different user groups. You can create 4 different types of user fields in Sharetribe: free text, number, select one, and select multiple. And you can limit these user fields to specific user types. Thanks for watching this video.